This video tutorial I will explain RESTful web services with POST request in XML example. By default, the Spring Boot application supports JSON request and responses, so we no need to add any additional dependencies. But if you want to send XML request, then we have to add this dependency, JSON data format XML. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application, which exposes REST endpoint for save employee details. Here you can see Postman client, and using Postman client, we can send or consume the RESTful web services exposed by Spring Boot demo application. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application with folder structure. Here you can see pom.xml. Here I have defined the class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age, and salary. And getter and setter methods for these four properties. Here I have overridden a toString method. Here I have defined the class employee controller, and it is REST controller. And it has save employee information method, which accept employee object, which is a request body. And to call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method is post. And inside this method, I am printing the employee object, and here we can write code to save the employee information in the database, and finally I am returning the employee object to the caller. Here I have defined a class application, which is a Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Using Postman client, I am going to send a save employee request to Spring Boot application. Here is the URL, and method is post. Click on body. And here we have to select raw, and we are going to send XML request. So select XML, and here you can see the employee object in XML format. Click on send. Request reaches here, and Spring Boot application automatically converts XML to employee object. Here we got the output. Next, we will send a JSON request and see what happens. Select JSON. Click on send, and Spring Boot application automatically converts JSON to employee object. Here we got the output. So now the Spring Boot application supports both JSON request and XML request. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.